Welcome, everyone. Please stand.
Please join in singing number 580, Sing to the Mountains, number 580.
Announcements. Father Tom and I and most priests from the diocese will be going to the clergy conference starts this afternoon in Alexandria until Wednesday. So we will be gone. Check the bulletin because there will be no masses Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. Pray for us as we go to our clergy conference, which is once a year. Women at the Well monthly women's retreat, first one will be held on October 12th. See the bulletin insert for more information. You all know about the Hurricane Helene. I don't know how to pronounce the name of that hurricane, but anyway, it went through Florida, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, and Tennessee. So the bishops of the United States have decided to have a second collection everywhere in our country next weekend. So next weekend, we're gonna have a second collection. These funds will go to Catholic Charities USA, the official domestic disaster relief agency of the Catholic Church in the United States. All donations received for disaster aid will be allocated to the Catholic Charities agencies providing critical relief, shelter, food, and other humanitarian aid. So next weekend, a second collection. Also, I would like to celebrate the birthday of Bernice Bodenheimer. Bernice is 96 today. So I will say a silent prayer of thanksgiving for you, Bernice, during this Mass. What a blessing, a long life, 96. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. My dear friends, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Almighty, ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us to pardon what conscience dreads and to give what prayer doesn't dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of various ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be a suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man this one has been taken. That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one flesh." The word of the Lord.
May the Lord bless us. blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. May the Lord bless us all the days of our life. May you see your children's children. Peace be upon Israel. May the Lord bless us all the days of our life.
A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, he, for a little while, was made lower than the angels, that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. For it was fitting that he, for whom and through whom all things exist, in bringing many children to glory, should make the leader to their salvation perfect through suffering. He who consecrates, and those who are being consecrated, all have one origin. Therefore, he is not ashamed to call them brothers. The word of the Lord.
From the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
The Pharisees approach Jesus and ask, "Is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife?" They were testing him. He said to them in reply, "What did Moses command you?" They replied, "Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her." But Jesus told them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." In the house, the disciples again questioned Jesus about this. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In the U.S., 41% of first marriages 41%, some people say 45% of first marriages end in divorce. 60% of second marriages and 73% of third marriages. No wonder why that famous actress in the 60s, Elizabeth Taylor, was married 8 times. To be honest, it is always difficult to preach on this gospel. We all know people who have suffered a divorce, and we feel for them. We also know good Catholics who are looking for the right person to marry, and they cannot find any, and we feel for them as well. I think the problem we have in our modern society is that we want fun, we want recreation, entertainment, without commitment. We just want to have fun. We want glory. We want glory without any sacrifice. We want resurrection without Good Friday. And too many people confuse falling in love with real love. All these pretty feelings, it must be love. In addition, the lack of a strong religious background, lack of religion. People are not practicing the faith, not going to church, leave couples unprepared to accept and leave out the obligation of marriage. So a lot of people come to the sacrament of matrimony not very well prepared. Another issue is that many couples choose to live together. Studies consistently show that couples who live together before marriage have a much higher divorce rate than couples who did not cohabitate. The studies indicate the rate to be 50%, 50, 50% higher. If breaking up is traumatic when you are just dating, breaking up of a cohabitation relationship is even more traumatic, is even more painful. The truth is that you cannot try out the commitment of marriage until you've made the commitment. Real life data shows that a trial run for marriage is not a good idea. In fact, it is a bad idea. Waiting patiently and prayerfully is a sacrifice that will pay in the long run. I'm going to make this sacrifice now, but it's for my future happiness. It's for my future long-lasting marriage. So waiting patiently and prayerfully is a good thing, very good thing. God is the creator of marriage and the source of all love and goodness. Fidelity to God is the most important ingredient for a happy marriage. Modern day research shows that couples who abstain from intimacy until marriage and go to church every weekend have greater marital happiness. 41 or 45% in the secular world, rate of divorce. Here in the church, people that go to church, less than 5%. Again, people that go to church, people that pray, people that know God, practice their faith, rate of divorce, less than 5%. Fidelity to God being in communion with God, having a very good relationship with God, is the main ingredient for a happy marriage and for a happy life in general. People that go to church have a lower rate of depression, suicide, anxiety, etc. So it is good for us, it is good for marriages to go to church, receive God's grace every weekend. Because without God's grace, we are prone to fail. You know, this commitment is just too much. I better give up. No. With God, you know, we persevere. He gives us what we need to persevere. My word of advice to all the single people who are looking for a good spouse: if the person you are dating sits down with you in these pews, prays with you, and sincerely love God, to me that's a powerful sign that you have found the one. You should consider marry that person. Spring Hill, they both deceased now, but in Spring Hill, when I was there in that parish, I met a couple. She said to me, we dated for 2 years. He lived almost 2 hours away, and I was here from Spring Hill. So we met at a dance, and he wanted to see me. So I said, okay, come to Spring Hill, go to church with me, meet my parents. I'm here. That guy, that man, drove every weekend for almost 2 hours to spend the whole day with her for almost 2 years. They went to church while they were dating. Guess what? When he proposed, she said, yes, you are the one. Because he was already making sacrifices as a groom, as a man who was dating this young woman. So that beautiful story really stayed with me. Now they both deceased. They were married for a long life, long time. And may the Lord bless their souls. If you are single because you have the vocation to be single, not everybody have to marry. You know, some people are single because that's a vocation. I would like to thank you for the good deeds you do, because single people have more time, you know, to be devoted to good causes. So thank you very much for your volunteer hours. And my word of encouragement to all those who have gone through a divorce, or you are grieving the loss due to death or separation: there is help out there. There is help. I didn't know the diocese, our diocese, offer retreats for people who have suffered a divorce, or they're grieving their loved one who died, or suffering a separation. It's called Beginning Experience. Beginning Experience. Check our diocesan website, Office of Marriage and Family. A lot of resources for people. So we have no excuse to stay there in that situation, you know, which is, you know, not good. There are people out there willing to help us. Resources. Marriage is something so sacred. It is a sacrament. God created man and then made the woman so that man would not be alone. Your husband, your wife, is your life companion. Love, respect, and faith are needed for that exclusive relationship to be fruitful. Marriage keeps the human race going. Thank you for being open to life. And good marriages tend to produce good people who will contribute to our society. Happy marriages tend to produce happy children. Stable marriages tend to produce a stable people. If you are married, keep nurturing your marriage. Don't be like those who expect heaven on earth from their marriage. And when it doesn't happen, they look elsewhere. Value your spouse. Pray together and do your best to make things work. Be prompt to forgive. The church has resources for married couples, marriage enrichment, marriage encounters, and also for struggling marriages. A lot of resources out there. Many marriages have been saved in the history of humanity. My parents, for example, were very close to separate, and now they're about to celebrate 50 years of marriage. They went through a very difficult time, like 15 years ago or so, and we, the children, really thought, this is it. They're going to separate. This is over. And my parents are still together. They survive with the grace of God that difficult time. So if your marriage needs help, do not hesitate to seek assistance. I will conclude by saying that marriage is sacred and no one has the right to violate its sacredness. Married couples need Christ as well as single people. We all need the Lord, for from Him we learn what real love is. When we look at the crucifix, okay, I get it. This is what real love is. Self-denial, dying to yourself, self-giving. God has taught us what real love is. Let us learn not to confuse falling in love with real love. Let us learn what it means to be responsible. Once I fulfill my responsibilities, then I have the right to take vacation. After I do my chores, then I can go outside and play. I learned that valuable lesson at home and in seminary was kind of reinforced it. We have to teach that to children. We have to teach that to our youth. You fulfill youth responsibilities first, and then we can talk about privileges. There is no glory without sacrifices. May the Lord help us all to be faithful to Him and to our commitments. We profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With confidence, we offer to God our petitions.
For Francis, our Pope, and Patrick, our Bishop, and all the clergy, with the people entrusted to their charge, we pray to the Lord. For the family of the human race, especially those who are most vulnerable, we pray to the Lord. For families broken by divorce or separation, that they may experience reconciliation and healing, we pray to the Lord. For an increase of love and devotion to the Blessed Mother during this month of the Most Holy Rosary, we pray to the Lord. For all of our seminarians and for more vocations to the priesthood, especially in the Diocese of St. Cloud, we pray to the Lord. For the safety of all of our local firemen, EMTs, and police officers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peaceful repose of the souls of the faithfully departed, especially Arnold and Dolores Lockowitzer, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, listen to our prayers that we offer to you today through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Number 802, One Love Released, number 802.
Church one.
Brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy
people. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service. Graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Therefore, this gift we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Patrick, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of God.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Seek to be one in Christ and one in heart and mind. Let all
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacrament which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume. Through Christ our Lord. Forgot to say that our deacons will be at the conference also. I don't want Deacon Richard to hold that against me. So deacons and priests will be gone this week, starting today, this afternoon, until Wednesday afternoon. Doing my homily preparation, I found a joke, and I tested this joke with Father Tom. He said, oh, that's good. So if you don't like the joke, talk to Father Tom. Send your complaint to him. One guy at the nursing home, he said to his pastor, you know, I'm getting bored here. I'm tired of playing bingo. I never win. So I want to get married. And the pastor said, but you're 94. Yeah, I know, but I want to get married. So who would you marry? He said, the girl next door. She's also 94. And he said to the pastor, asked him, do you love her? He said, no. Huh. Oh, yeah, maybe you ran out of money and she got a lot of money? No, no. He said, no, that's not, yeah. Okay, why do you want to marry her? Because she can still drive at night. Those goofy jokes that people come out with. Thank you all for coming. Thank you, choir, mass server, everybody. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go forth, the mass is ended. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection, snares of the devil.
By the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Number 609, for the beauty of the earth, number 609.